The Bundaberg Rum Rugby Series is set to kick off here on Australian soil. We're awaiting the two sides. They've met on 20 previous occasions, Australia winning 13, Scotland 7. And Australia has a very good record here at Telstra Dome. Just the one loss, and that was to England last year, pre-Rugby World Cup. So the fans, as you'd expect, with Scotland and Australia, are decked out appropriately. And joining me in commentary, a couple of Wallaby legends, Tim Horan and Dan Crowley.
Well, isn't it fantastic, Goran? The fact the Australian team, they're all looking forward. They're pumped up to the start of this season.
And big Scott Murray, British and Irish Lions, in the absence of Chris Patterson, leading out this Scottish side. Patterson so tragically suffered a triple fracture of his cheekbone against the Samoans in the Test victory by 38-3 last week. Sean Lamont with that peroxided hair on the wing for Scotland. And this side has been much maligned, Tim Horan. They've been written off by all of the Australian media. They'll relish their status here today.
But I think also, Gordon, they're quietly confident. They've been playing some outstanding rugby coming into this game, especially against Samoa, and Scott Murray leading the team out.
We're playing for the Hopetoun Cup after the early Governor General of Australia, Lord Hopetoun, and Tom Smith. What a warrior! Played for the Lions here in Australia in 2001. But looking at this Scotland lineup, just the two changes from the victory over Samoa last week in Wellington, and they come in the back line. At number 10, Daniel Parks, whose nickname when he was playing in Sydney was Compass, because he played for Easts, Wests and Souths. The other change being Hugo Southwell, number 15 at fullback, coming in for the injured Chris Patterson. Very experienced man on the bench, number 21, Gordon Ross. So that was a close decision for the fly half role, with the Sydney side and the former Sydney side of Daniel Parks getting the nods.
Well, Gordon Ross on the bench tonight, and a lot rides on Dan Parks' shoulder to make sure that his team plays down the other end of the field. They must keep pressure under the Wallabies all night.
There's Daniel Parks, top centre, alongside the ball head there of Webster, and now George Gregan. This magnificent warrior and captain of Australia. His career really kick-started in Melbourne. He was replaced in Brisbane in 94 in his initial test against Italy, and then he played here at Olympic Park and then went on to pull off that great tackle against Jeff Wilson at Aussie Stadium. But 10 years on, he's still in that gold jumper and leading this crack Wallaby outfit, Radiki Samo. Well, you can imagine the scenes in Fiji with Randike Samo in the Wallaby jumper for the first time. And they get a rousing ovation from this crowd, which must be pushing up towards 40,000.
What a great atmosphere. George Gregan and his team, they've waited a long time since that loss in the World Cup final in late November.
The Aussie lineup then. Well, there are just 11 of the starting 15 that began the World Cup final against England on November 22 last year at Telstra Stadium. Joe Roth coming back into the side. He came on just in the 73rd minute of the World Cup final, but he's been in scintillating form in Super 12. And there have been injuries. We have this exciting centre pairing of Matt Gitto and Clyde Rathbone. Rathbone in the number 13, and another Fijian in the side, Lottie, as they call him in Fiji, Tungiri, Lottie Takiri, the blockbusting winger for the Wallabies.
Isn't it great to see that he announced during the week that he is staying with Rugby Union? He's going to New South Wales, but I don't think it mattered which state he went to, as long as he was playing the game of Rugby Union.
Standing by then for the national anthems. Rugby anthem for Scotland, Flower of Scotland.
Fought and died for your women.
Scots play at Murrayfield, they are greeted by Princess Anne, who is an avid Scotland supporter. Justin Harrison, his locking partner Nathan Sharp. We're coming to a test match, guys. It's about showing your true colours. And we've certainly seen that here today at Telstra Dome.
Well, we can see the Scottish true colours. Did you see the head on that singer there? He wasn't pretty, was he? They mean business.
He's obviously an ex-prop forward. And Walsing Basilda sets the scene as the two sides now prepare for this opening kickoff. Said he had to brush up on the words of the anthem and also Walsing Matilda, and some of those words slurred by members of the crowd. But Paul Honus from New Zealand, he presides in Hamilton in the North Island, and he's the man who had the opening World Cup match on October 10 last year between Australia and Argentina. Bundaberg Rum Rugby Series 2004, kick-started by the Scots. Australia in possession through Justin Harrison. Stephen Larkin with a cutout pass to Joe Roth and into space immediately. Southwick on his left boots, not his best kick, and Roth on the 10 metre line.
Wait here, guys.
And this is Webster. Ball comes from Daniel Parks. Well, Daniel Parks left for Scotland last September, and here he is now wearing the national jumper.
White line, blue. Scott, good kick, please. Three in, one receiver.
One.
Bring it on the white line. Well, guys, I want you half a metre off the line. A half metre off the line, he's fine.
Left ball, he's laying down the law. He knows what he wants.
Harrison to Sharp and Larkin charging onto the ball over the advantage line. 38 metres out. Quick ball for the Aussies. Cannon. David Lyons was there. The Australian support runners queuing up. Now Gitto. Joe Roth in the line. Slicing. And inside the quarter. What a hot start here by the Wallabies. But that last pass going to ground. And that's Ben Hitchelwood. Another Australian who's playing in this Scottish team. And Hitchelwood. Dad, his father Sandy, played 21 test matches for Scotland.
Off the mark here, Blue.
Radicky Somo taking his first hit up in test football. And we see Joe Roth going through. But George Smith was the player who actually pushed that last pass. Didn't really need to be thrown.
Here's our mark. I want your team half a metre off the mark, please. It's fine. Get it across and we'll do it. Come across, Blue. Come across. Right, where you are. Let's
go. Don't you like it how the referee says come across and no one moves?
Not too convincing. This is Rathbone with his first touch. 10-metre line, Scotland territory.
Seven Blue.
We're into the third minute of this opening test match. And not George Gregan's best kick, but
Blue seven, I want you off the tackler, please. You're slowing the ball down. Roll away.
So he was playing advantage, and one of the Scottish players slowing the ball down.
As we mentioned before the game started, that is exactly what they're going to do all night. That is going to be Paul Honus's hardest time. Do I just keep penalising the Scottish, or do I send someone off?
Chance for Joe Robb. It's straight out in front, 40 metres to the goalposts. It's a comfortable start here for Joe Roth, certainly within his kicking range. The 28-year-old in his 83rd test. Accuracy, the keynote here. Flags in the affirmative, and first points for the Wallabies.
Well, Joe Roth is a confident sort of player. I'm sure the Super 12 was an outstanding Super 12 for the Brumbies at 15. And tonight here with the Wallabies, at fullback for the Wallabies, but he needs that confident start which he's taken there.
Scots were penalised against Samoa. Their first penalty was slowing the ball down at the tackle. It's been repeated here against the Australians. And there you saw Justin Harrison taken out in the air before he received the ball. Referee playing advantage here.
Advantage over.
Another long cut out to Roth. Gitto to Kiris on his outside. Probably should have received
holding
it.
Blue. Hold. So no, you're not. Hold.
Southwell. Okay. With a raking kick back inside the in-goal area.
Well, certainly the intentions early on from the Wallabies to spread the ball wide. Stephen Larkin's first two passes have been cut
not
out.
Interference with the kickoff, Blue. Go for the ball, not the man. Get them back behind you, please.
Harrison has all the rights in that situation. Can't interfere with the player once he's off the ground. Good depth there from Larkham and not taken by Scott Murray. And he got a little nudge there from Harrison as a congratulatory gesture.
What line?
Harrison can't help himself, can he? Just giving goal, a little bit of a gutful. Just make sure he remembers it.
Down your line, Blue. No option. You took it outside the arms, five. Option, scrum all line out, Gold.
Not in straight.
Scrum all line out, Gold.
Well, Paul Honus 15. Has spoken about what he wants in that line out, and Blue
hole.
Didn't
close
do
to
it.
The mark, Blue.
First scrum of the game.
No ball, stay up, stay up. No ball. Scratch and hold. Engage. Let's go, half. Same ground, flankers.
Well wheeled by Scotland.
And taken off, away by rush. David Lyons, 10-metre line, Australian territory. Wallabies ahead 3-0. And Larkham's kick has gone straight to Southwell. He won't be happy with that one. And on his favourite left boots. Some perfect positioning there by Joe Roth.
Holding goal. Holding.
Larkham electing to kick the ball straight down the field. He was inside his 22, but inviting Scotland to run it back, they don't. Instead, Parks looks for the touchline. Quick throws on here for Dakiri.
Well, the Scottish team certainly won that kicking duel. Stephen Larkham has been doing a lot of work during the week with his kicking coach, Ben Perkins. And Dan Parks definitely won that duel with a great kick down into the Wallabies half.
Blue, off the mark. Here's our mark. Bring them across, please, two. Bring your players across.
Must be a 4 metre gap. Game well done by Harrison. What a pass from Gregan. Rathbone charging on.
Hands off. No ball, advantage.
Gregan taken out without the ball there by Ali Hogg. Advantage play. Two Kiris out there. Hungry for work. Gregan, well, that's Sailor out there. Same haircut. Wallabies keeping the ball alive and really testing the Scottish defence. 37 metres out. Larkham. Cannons out wide.
Time, blue hands away.
Just outside the corner.
Blue's 13. Right was formed, you use your hands.
Ben Hitchell, the man penalised.
You can't use your hands to win the ball.
So the referee's saying a ruck was formed. There were at least one player from either side in contact over the ball.
Seven,
and in
blue.
That situation, you hands can't away. Use your hands. Feet only.
Well, the Wallabies have been the ones who have been doing all the attacking so far tonight. They haven't even had to make one tackle. So they've had all the possession. And they decided to go for the line out to keep the pressure on the Scots.
Well, the big thing that Australia have to do is make sure they keep the composure and just keep playing to the set play. At the moment, you can hear they're talking to each other, which is exactly what they need to be doing.
Nathan Sharp. Distinctive blue headgear. Radiki. Samo, number six, closest. Scott's doing a good job of trying to spoil so far. Was the spoiler. Here's Dakiri. All on the World Cup final. Dakiri couldn't hold on this time. Scotland up the hook. And that's the exciting youngster, Sean Lamont.
Wasn't it a lovely place kick from Stephen Larkham? He was under pressure. And as you said, Gordon, like very early on in the World Cup final, Dakiri just couldn't get off the ground.
Back on the touchline.
Australia's driving more, proving very effective, and setting up that attacking kick from Stephen Larkham. So Daniel Parks to Sailor. The crowd gets excited when Big Dell gets the ball. Out wide now to Roth. And taken in a copybook tackle by Ben Hinchelwood. Just short of halfway. Wallabies ahead 3-0. This is Samo. 10 from halfway. Smith into scrum half.
Oh, he was onside.
He's the Indian rubber man.
Hands off, blue.
So elusive and slippery. Roth again. Rathbone with the big palm off. Tremendous defence from the Scots. Hinchelwood forcing the error from Australia. Forget that kick, Joe. Now it's Grimes. Scotland with their defence really bustling the Australians into mistakes. And now in a great attacking position, Lamont. It's Nathan Sharp with a driving tackle. He was over the top. Another man underneath. 27 metres out. Now they set up a rolling ball. Headway. Is there a more four? It's all Scots at the moment.
It's important that the Scottish keep the ball at the back of the ruck so the Australians can't get anywhere near it, but now it's breaking
Stay
away.
On. Off blue.
Either way now. stick. Malcolm there trying his best. But it's out in front, man on man here. White managed to slip the pass outside. Cassidy into scrum half to Parks.
You running ahead of the ball carrier, that's obstruction, taking a player out of the game.
Unfortunate there for the Scots because they were really putting a lot of heat on the Aussie defence.
Well, gee, early on I thought that they put a lot of pressure when Australia had the ball, forced the mistake, forced Joe Roth to turn and kick, and at last Scotland got their hands on the ball and tried to get into their patterns of play early in the game.
The ball carrier had a man in front of him there who appeared to be obstructing the Scottish or the Aussie defence. And that was Joe Ross. Wobbly old kick, one he'll want to forget.
He'd be happy if it was Bulls.
Make the chart that time. Very flat pass to Rathbone. Over the fullback to Banks. Smith in support, as always. George Gregan quickly to Sharp. Samo first there to clean out. That's the quarter line. Australia ready to go again through Gitto and Rathbone, who made that incisive break. Joe Roth comes in.
Back up, Blue.
They etch inside the quarter. Lyons pass is knocked down.
No advantage, offside, midfield.
And it's going to be a goal kick. They can't ignore this one right in front of the post. Offside in the centre of the field.
Beautiful flat pass by Gregan and steaming onto a Rathbone. But what you saw there was beautiful work. He had backup behind him and kept presence of mind to be able to pop it up, and that's what kept the play going.
Australia ahead by 3-0. Successful here, Joe Roth will become the fifth Wallaby in history to reach 200 test points after Michael Leiter, Matthew Burke, David Campese and Paul McLean. A milestone for Joe Roth as Australia's out to a 6-0 lead.
Everybody knew that the Scottish were going to be tenacious, especially in their defence. What they're doing really well so far is the fact that they're getting off the defensive line. Every time there's a line, you'll see them rush up at the Australians, get in their face and deny them time and space. If they keep that going, they will make sure they cause Australia problems.
Parks' kick has gone too deep. Just not putting enough pressure on Lyons, who's made 10 metres comfortably.
Off the foot, play on, off the foot!
Pillage though, by the Scots, a little customer. Great hands here from Murray. Smith put it down. Cassidy again. He's been in charge of Mike Laird. Up and out spot. That's Andrew Henderson. Brendan Cannon gives him a welcome party on the 22. Marks again to Hinchwood. And hasn't he been impressive, particularly with his defence in the early stages? Scotland working well through Smith and Grimes, and also Murray. Parks again. Fullback to Sharp. Very impressive build-up here from the Scots. But this is where they continually let themselves down in 2004. They can't sustain it. Now to Kiri, looking to punish. And that really must be a heartbreak for the coaching staff, because they did all the good work there and then self-destructed.
Off seven!
David Lyons, Sailor, bit of space, what a step, and what a tackle. His bringer, Lyons, Gitto, that's it. First try to the Wallabies. His first start at inside centre. kicks in double figures.
Well, it all started from a mistake in the Wallabies 22 by the Scottish team. They were keeping it close. And then we see Greig came onto the ball. Lovely little flick pass back inside the lines. They kept the ball alive. And Giddo, ever present, pinned his ears back 40 metres out. And the Scottish team weren't going to stop him.
Beautiful work by Lyons there. He didn't try and overplay his hand. George Greig and getting good quick service. He's having a wonderful game so far, Lyons. But he realises his play. Beautiful ball again. Presence of mind by Saylor. He knew he's allowed to play the ball off the ground. And then Giddo, the speed man on the inside, hitting it hard, hitting it straight and hitting it fast. But what's the problem at the moment? In the background, Stephen Larkham, the receiving attention. That is concern.
Joe Rock from a very handy position here. And the Scots already under the hammer. They defended gallantly, but they ran out of numbers. 13-0 to the Wallabies. Daniel Parks then to get things underway. He made his debut against Wales in the Six Nations this year. This is his second start in the test. He started March 27 against the Irish. And Saylor, who sent little halfback Cusseter into Gaga land after the lead up to that first try. Was that Takiri or it was Bandiki Samo? He's a versatile man, but kicking's not one of his fortes.
You think they would have been able to pick the difference in their hairstyle, wouldn't you?
The Scots looking to bounce back here. And Tom Smith is leading the way. The ball's been lost ahead.
Scotland, number two, lost control of it, lost it forward. Scrum down, goal ball.
Seemed to be an Aussie hand in there to spoil.
You can still see the Scottish game plan keeping it close. They only had three or four backline members outside of them. Trying to keep the ball close, and they were gaining momentum.
You can see the main thing he was doing there was trying to feed the ball back, get it back away from the Australian defence.
Straight spine and bind up, please. Straight spine. Crouch and hold. Engage.
Keep it straight, don't pack on an angle. Good scrum, Australia.
David Lyons with some quality running in the first quarter of the game. Larkham now from deep defence. And again, quite happy to keep the ball in play. Webster to Lamont. And this is Hinchelwood. Takes on Takiri. Hinchelwood plays for Worcester, who've just been promoted to the Premier English League. Southwell offloading there to White. Gordon Bullock. Good tackle by Gregor. Ball and all.
What Australia aren't doing at the moment is they're committing no men to the breakdown and going in a flat defence. Great hit there by Samar. That's good stuff.
Well, there would have been a big roar in the village of Narewa in Nandi. There's 500 people around a TV set in Joe Lagula's village. After that tackle.
I need you behind the offside line.
And that's the sort of tackle that he produced in the Super 12 final in that opening 20-minute blitzkrieg by the Brumbies against the Crusaders.
A pole driver, wasn't he? Picked him up. Underneath his legs, hooked and bang.
Big Sure Grimes, he loves running with the ball, but if he's going to keep copying that, I don't think he's going to be doing it too often.
Australia 13-0. Keep him here.
I'm
Daniel Park scored nearly 200 points for Eastern Suburbs last season in Sydney. And what a moment here, his first penalty shot at goal. On Australian soil. You can't do any better than that. Marvellous effort by Daniel Parks, the 26-year-old from Glasgow. And Scotland on the board. Big, deep sigh of relief.
Yeah, that's given him a great boost of confidence. He knows that he's under a lot of pressure. But he wants, once you get that sweet strike through and you start, the things start going well, hopefully it'll flow on for the rest of his game.
Played by Scotland first, play on!
Didn't quite go the 10 metres, but because the Scots played the ball, the referee said, we keep going. Charged down, bring it, the try's off him!
You're accidentally offside, mate.
And get apparently the ball. Stay there. And Greg was in front of him, so accidentally offside was the ruling.
Accidentally offside because he played the glass.
And a little bit below the belly button, that's scrum, absolutely scrum. Dropped him. He's usually got a fairly low voice, but it's got a bit higher, I think.
Well, he lost his voice after the Super 12 final through all the celebrations.
That's got to hurt.
Tim, you've played a bit of cricket.
What do they say? Just count them.
So a big Rantiki Samo, his younger brother Ravuama, is in the Fijian squad. He's 122 kilogram prop.
Yeah, you've got to wait for my call. Engage. Blue tight head. I want you square and hitting on the up, please. Closer to the mark. Wait a minute, Blue. Do it properly for me, please. Crouch and hold.
As soon as the props engage, they've got to make sure they take the ball.
Engage. Settle. Staying on, flankers.
Wallaby scrum tries to wheel and put the acid on. Scotland hold on pretty well. There's Grimes. Larkin is the tackler. Cushida. And that's Southwell on his left foot. Joe Roth, last line. 30-metre pass to Dakiri. Rathbone supporting. And this is Parks. Hugo Southwell, the 26-year-old from Edinburgh, gets his touch and he's gone over the halfway line. Enjoying his first run-on start for Scotland.
Scott, get please, Scott.
Harrison got a hand and then recovered brilliantly. Gitto. Rathbone. Hits him with number 13. So they covered up pretty well, the Scots, but Australia get quick ball. Dakiri. Larkin. Big Nathan Show. Larkin to Dakiri again. Sano is out there. So to Rathbone. And that's excellent cover defence from the Scots.
Australia are working the Scottish from one side of the field to the other, but they're up to it at the moment. And big defence, they picked Rathbone up and just dragged him across the sideline. Scotland so far, tackle-wise, have missed 8, Australia none. But conversely, line breaks, Australia 3, Scotland none.
The score at Telstra Dome, Australia 13, leading Scotland 3. Donald, where's your trousers? There's a nasty right eye for Nathan Sharp. He'll have a real shiner. And the eye looks as though it may have closed over after this incident.
Well, that's actually the eye that he had operated on about 2 weeks ago, so I'm sure he's a little bit worried about that at the moment.
Nathan bit sharp though. No advantage able from to there. Spoil the pass of Cassita, but he knocked on in doing so. Yes, he actually had stitches in that eye.
Australia here will be trying to push the side of the scrum up and push it into touch.
Taken ahead by Henderson, and he's made good ground there, 7 or 8 metres. And not a lot of distance on that ball from Parks. He was looking for another 20. We're 35 out from the Scottish goal line.
You can see very early on the Scottish inside backs, Henderson and Hitchell, trying to set a platform for their number 10, Dan Parks, to give him a better position, kicking for the touch.
Wait up. We've got the gap closing, and we've got goal jumping early. Let's have it again. Same conditions apply. Goal lineouts. Let's have our gap blue and hold the gap, please.
So the Scots are past masters.
Two faults. You close the gap as well as
spoiling the opposition line out. And they're able to do that by subtly closing that 1 metre gap.
No early jumping goals.
He's got 1.5 metres here.
Play on. That was double. Play on. They played each other out.
Here's Takiri. That pass looked to be forward. And there was some obstruction as well.
Australia trying to use the decoy runner. They just got in the way there. The tackle was impeded by the decoy runner. Yeah, I think George Smith accidentally got in the front of Takiri. And Scotland now can go inside the Wallabies half.
This is the platform where Scotland have got to start using their backs, start using some of their moves. They've got a good line out. They know that they should be assured of winning their own ball. And this is where we want to see them attack, not just use their feet.
So Nathan Sharp did well. It was lost ahead by Grimes. All three players advantage. Baxter cleaning up. Takiri, quickly to Smith. But there was an initial knock on by the Scots Australian scrum feet.
Once again, we see the Australians going to the short side. It's about the fourth or fifth time they're really working the short side and trying to catch the Scottish out.
Break up, you're moving off the mark. You've got to wait for my call, front rows. Wait for my call. Here we are, crouch and hold. Engage.
A tidy ball for Lyons. He's well and truly roughed up, but then the support arrived. Rathbone taken by Henderson. Roth comes in to clean out. Bergen again probing on that short side. Smiley passed by Webster. Roth in his first receiver. This is Lyons again. Good low tackling from the Scots. But Australia maintaining possession. Gitto. Smith. Over the halfway. And taken away by Cassita. This is Hogg.
No advantage. Lost forward in the tackle. Goals.
But George Smith holding the ball in one hand. Losing ahead.
Eddie Jones will be disappointed so far in parts of the game that the Australians have been playing. He's very strict on discipline. He wants to make sure that every time they have the ball, they use it well. We see George Smith, he's put the big fend out there and he's looking for the inside ball, but he should have actually just taken it to ground and then set the phase up. Instead, lose it, turnover.
This is young scrum half Chris Cassita, who's really toiled hard so far. 13-3 to the Wallabies.
Interestingly enough, you see that Australia aren't getting good quick ball because the Scottish are working very hard at the breakdown. Conversely, Australia at the moment are putting no men in and they're giving the Scottish easy ball for second and third phase play.
Hogg kicking that ball right on the floor. Unfortunately, there was no fullback, but a good Australian scrum putting the Scots under pressure. Strong work by Donny McFadgen. And Scotland having a crack now. To the halfway line. Haven't seen much of their outside backs at all. That's Grimes.
Roll off, Tim.
But it's all a bit one-dimensional at the moment. Parks to Lamont. Young was over the top, Markham underneath. Henderson quickly to Hitchell. Southwell pulled down by Henderson. Scotland's best attack with ball in hand. Ball went straight down. No knock on. I think that was the call from the touch judge. No knock on it, went straight to ground. Tom Smith.
Can't play advantage. You're causing obstruction there. No. First infringement was offside and midfield by goals. Okay, mate, you can't stand there and obstruct their player coming forward to tackle your ball carrier, all right?
So the net result is that the Scots are going to get a penalty out in front of the post.
Behind the hindmost foot, and the player with the ball must go in front of you.
Pointing Scotland's way. I think they're all a bit confused.
And the player with the ball has got to go in front of you, not behind you.
Here we see Scotland going wide again. But what they're doing very well is they're tying up Stephen Larkham, George Smith and David Lyons. They're heading very close to the ruck and they're tying these players up and then waiting for their opportunity to go wide.
Do you understand, mate?
This is a gift, you would think, for Daniel Parks. He could just about blow it over from there.
Doesn't he give a great view from the axe angle there of exactly what needs to be done?
This then to close the gap to just a converted try. 7 points. And no mistake from Daniel Parks. And the Bonnie Scots trailing Australia by those 7 points.
I think Matt Williams, the Scottish coach, will be fairly pleased so far. The Scottish side have been up front foot with their defence. The Wallabies haven't been able to get to their pattern of play apart from a couple of times, but the handling errors, the Wallabies 5 and the Scottish 3, to show you how much the Wallabies are trying to attack.
The Scots are playing the ball again, it didn't go in the 10 metres, but Webster comes away. Scotland very positive in their approach. Happy to get on with play. Grimes has taken a lot of the ball directly ahead. So too Smith and Cassidy. Now Parks looking for open territory and the touchline. And that's how you do it. Now they can put on some pressure inside the quarter.
But now they're playing to their strengths. They're playing to their line-out. They get good, solid ball, even though the last time I said that, I gave them the kiss of death. But now they've got to use their backs. They showed before that their backs have got skills and they can cause some dents in the Australians, but they've got to use them.
Justin Harrison superb two-handedly to foil the Scots. They were looking for a poach there. And Larkham gaining only 10 metres. So this is Scotland's chance before the break. And you can hear the Australians saying that is a forced turnover. Not a great option there by the Scots. They tried to catch Australia napping.
Well, there the view from the Qantas wing cam. It was up to two, pushed back to the hooker again. Matt Williams will be livid about that. Perfect position for them to go, and they blow it.
So, again, the rebound from Murray. And that's the charging David Lyons and Sabo. 8 metres from the halfway line. Larkham putting a bit of sanity into it with a raking kick to the corner line. This is Southwell. And Takiri now with a chance to counter. Solidly met by the Scottish fullback. Takiri has set it beautifully for Gregan. You see Webster trying to reef the ball out. And that's Nathan Sharp, supported by Harrison. Regan did well to clear that one under pressure. Larkham takes off. A little bit of space here for the Wallabies. But the gap closes.
No, holding on. Sim was on his feet. He's got all right to the ball.
This is a good test for the Wallabies. Getting put under a lot of pressure. And not getting across the advantage line. So they're not getting clean, quick ball. Keary fumbled, then flicked it out right-hand side, looking for his teammate, Saylor.
Great catch and slips by Saylor. Did good work, put his body on the line. But unfortunately, then didn't have the backup. The Scottish came over the top. And Wendell holding onto the ball, waiting just that fraction too long, and penalised for not releasing the ball.
Wendell Saylor was isolated. And in that situation on the ground, when there are players from the opposition team on their feet trying to get at the ball, you've got to release it. Penalty offence.
And the old coach, Bob Dwyer, used to say it's not the man on the ground who's at fault, it's his backup player going over the top.
Daniel Parks has been something of a hero so far for Scotland. Can he nail this one? Beautiful strike again. He's got the distance. 4 points in it. The Scottish bench and their fans absolutely delighted here at Telstra Dome. 13th place nine.
Very similar to the World Cup quarterfinal at Suncorp Stadium. Both sides very close. Not long to go in the first half. The Wallabies need to get their hands on the ball as Larkham goes long.
Taken by Murray. He really took ownership of that high ball. What a quality forward he is. Back with Parks. Something different. They look for the left boot of Southwell. And he replies in kind up towards halfway.
I think Southwell has been really well positioned tonight. He's picked off a couple of Stephen Larkham's longer kicks. And he's got a very big left foot on him. And he's only a young guy, but he's playing very well tonight so far.
You would have played against him, Tim. He was with the Bristol Shoguns. He's played for them for three seasons. He's been playing on the wing mainly, up to us so far.
Get in, Connell.
Taken away by Murray again. Storming effort by him in this first half. Inspirational. And number six, Jason White, lends his support. Great effort here by the Scottish forwards. They are taking it to the Wallaby eight at the moment. Cassidy goes in. Parks looking for Lamont. And easily read by Joe Rock.
Yeah, good work, Joe. Now just takes his time, settles it down. This is the danger period for both teams. Australia will want to score, but they will also want to make sure that they don't let the Scottish put points on before halftime, and he should have put that out.
There's a wild pass from Southwell, but Parks is back here. And Scotland are going to have a crack at the Australians near halfway. This is Hinchelwood, given a hospital pass, five from halfway. This is Gordon Bullock. Good clean out from McFadgen. White just caught by the bootlace. Lyons got in the way and has pitched it for Australia. I think it was Nathan Sharp actually. Now Joe Roth. And this time he gets the touch. Just outside the quarter line. 13-9 to the Wallabies.
Nathan Sharp, Wallaby vice captain, just getting in the way. Clyde Rathbone in his first test match. He's had seven hit ups so far, really getting involved.
Wasn't straight, but getting at the right numbers, goal. One too many. Back 15.
So the ball wasn't thrown in straight by Scotland, but Australia, because they weren't throwing the ball in, had to acknowledge the number of men in the lineup for Scotland. And Australia had one man too many, so that's a free kick, not a penalty. Which means you can't kick it out on the full from that situation. Unless you're inside the 22. Cassata to Parks. And they're happy to play for territory here as they close on half-time. Lottie Takiri and Joe Roth. And nothing fancy in this situation. So Australia with a four-point lead, but looking decidedly rusty in this first half.
I think Matt Williams has got Dan Parks to play to the game plan exactly right. It's keeping the ball close. When there's not an opportunity, he'll put the ball down in the other end of the field and put Australia's line out of the pressure.
his assistant, former All Black skipper Todd Blackadder. It's Jason Weiss. He's also had a very powerful game in this first half at number six.
No, the jumper went on with the interference at line-out time in 15. Blue penalty.
So Australia's discipline letting them down here. The man was pulled down in the air.
Justin Harrison going up. He's allowed to compete in the air, but as he comes back down, he's tried to drag his opposite man down by the jumper.
And wouldn't Scotland love to go in at half-time only down by a point? Had Chester be out, they'll jog straight to the dressing room. And Matt Williams will be very pleased if he gets this kick.
I think Justin Harrison was pretty hard done by there. He's talking about taking the man out, but he was actually caught with a person underneath him, and he was caught in no man's land. But the Scottish, they'll take the 3 points any way they can get it.
Message for the Australians there is that they just can't afford to have any indiscretion, even though Harrison looked to be harshly treated. This would close the gap to just 1 point. So what a turn-up here at Telstra Dome. Who would have thought that the Scots would be within a point at half-time? 13th place, 12. Wallaby coach Eddie Jones laying down the law at half-time. His Wallaby Chargers ahead by just 13-12. Scotland with four penalty goals by Daniel Parks. The Wallabies getting the only try of that first half. But really, they have to focus up, stiffen up, and come out and perform up front in this second 40 minutes, because an upset is on the cards at the moment. With me in commentary, former Wallaby internationals Dan Crowley and Tim Horan.
Well, Australia knew that they were going to be in for a tough game. The Scottish pride won't let it be any other way. But they now have to put them to the sword. They have to now pick it up. They have to lift the intensity and lift the speed of the game against the Scottish so that they can blow them away in the second half. But also on that, what they've got to do at the breakdown, they've got to make the Scottish earn the ball. They've got to put some more men around the ball and make them work for it.
See all the Wallaby players in fresh jerseys.
Stephen Larkin gets the second half underway. 13-12 to the Wallabies at the break. And the Scots very excited. They're in a huddle.
Hello, fellas. Scrum down. Goal ball.
Next job, Hoggle.
Yes, they're in a huddle just before kickoff, realising that they've played above themselves in that opening 40 minutes. Trying to muscle up. Sidely met by Jason Weiss. Now Larkin to Rathbone. And it's Henderson who wraps him up inside the quarter. Good start here for the Wallabies. Sharp. Cregan. Takiri. 5 metres to go. Scotland on their heels. Cregan again.
Come back, Blue.
That's the goal line. Stephen Larkin.
Let him play it, Blue.
Joe Rock going into clean out.
Cross forward.
And the referee
cross
spotted.
Forward, goal 10, out 5, scrum blue ball.
That little hand on the ball, losing it ahead. So Scotland hang on by the skin of their teeth.
Well, the Wallabies working the sideline again, and Qantas Wingcamp picks up the great ball from Greg into Takiri. And Southwell did very well to put him to ground. The Wallabies have been working the short side again early in the second half.
Australia then, no change to the halftime lead, 13-12. Chris Cusseter, number 9.
Over the mark, office, over the mark. Crouch and hold. Engage.
Big scrum from the Australians. but Ali Hawk did well in the number eight position. Scratch have recovered.
No way.
The huge shot there from the Australian scrum. Australia will be wanting to kick. Scott's pinned down here.
That's fine.
It's a good clearing kick and just takes a bit of the heat off to the 22-metre line.
New forwards coach Andrew Blades has said the Australians have been working hard on their scrum in pre-season and it's starting to pay dividends already.
Over the head there of Sharp. Turnover for Scotland. McFadden. And that's the third line-out steal by the Scots.
No, off the feet.
Timing just askew for the Wallabies. Between thrower and jumper is Joe Roth. Sailor's out here and he has a bit of space. Samo. Driven back at the tackle there by Gordon Bullock. Turnover. Tom Smith, the prop forward. Southwell gets involved. And Hinchwood down inside the Aussie quarter. Joe Roth to Dekiria. Here's the cutter. Rathbo, the quickest man in the Australian team. Over 40 metres. Splendid counter from the Australians. 38 metres out now.
Untidy, guys. We've got players on the ball here. Going forward, Gold. Your scrum block.
Rathbo going full tilt there. Southwell putting his body on the line. He's gone straight at him. Isn't Rathbo having a great game?
Good vision by Joe Roth to switch with Larkham and find Dekiria wide and Rathbone in full flight. Needed a quick ball here, Australia, and they didn't get it.
Scratch and hold. I want you on your own props.
Switches.
Australia, we've got to try and keep the scrum straight. They'll bring it up towards the
referee. You were warned.
They pushed Australia off the mark before the ball had got in. And David Lyons has made 25 metres inside the quarter again.
Stay on.
Larkham. Larkham! Cannon was looming inside. This is Samo. Just couldn't offload, but secure this time in the tackle.
No advantage. Lost forward by Blue. Post tackle. Thank you, guys. Scrum goal ball.
David Lyons off the free kick, as he did so much in the World Cup last year, carting two or three players across the advantage line.
Steady on your feet.
McFadden holding on. Lyons set the platform for the Wallabies.
Engage. Let's go, half.
Strong attacking platform for the Wallabies. Roth has joined. The ball came a little slowly. And Rathbo on the angle. Harrison to Gregan. It's Baxter. Bill Young trying to clean out. Larkham. And he's lost the ball.
Again,
it was an excellent tackle. It might have been Jason White at that time. Daniel Parks, number 10 versus number 10, White assisting.
Larkham sniping again. The third time in this half, second half, that he's had a few runs himself. He needs some players to run off him.
13-12 at Telstra Dome, Australia's way.
Both hitting square. Scratch and hold.
In he goes.
And done.
Come right, 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 right.
Kilos plus on either side, crunching together in that scrum. As Webster into scrum half. Park's not getting the territory he wanted. Australia's throw into the line out this time. Can they get it right?
Goal, goal!
Nathan Sharp to Gregan. First tackle there from McFadden. But again, the ball slowed down. Larkham, Roth, Larkham on the loop, overlap to Kerry, and the second try for the Wallabies. They made it look easy. But that's been the key for the Australians. They've simplified their running and passing in the second half, and there's some immediate results.
Well, they've really put their foot down on the accelerator now, the Wallabies. Watch the ball from Joe Roth. Takes the two defenders. That allows Larkham to put Rathbone and then to carry away out wide.
Good handling by the Australians, but the Scottish were their own worst enemy. They didn't come off the defensive line. They didn't try and take away the space from the Australians. And when Dakiri got the ball, they were still in the same position. He just had to finish it off, and finish it off well he does.
Well, when Wendell Saylor took that ball through the middle, he took out all the back row of the Scottish players, which didn't allow the Scottish defence to drift, and that was the key to the try.
The $1.6 million man, Lodi Tukiri, he's just signed for three more years with the Waratahs, gets his sixth test try, and now it's with Joe Roth from touch. Straight ahead by 18 to 12. Converted try for the Scots would have them in the lead.
Well, I wonder what Eddie Jones said at half time. I reckon he would have put a rocket up these Wallabies. I think he was very disappointed in that first 40 minutes of the control of the ball. The Wallabies need to play a lot more direct rugby.
Scotland looked as though they're pilfered from the restart.
Accidental offside, with no advantage, we're coming here for the knock-on by Goals.
So Harrison, not able to hold the ball from the kick-off. He lost a head, and then some accidental offside. So good sporting by Grimes, and that man ruled in front of Grimes after he had got in the way.
Engage. Engage, fellas, no one at fault. A little bit closer, please, fellas. Just give your face a bit of a wipe. Crouch and hold. Closer goal to the mark, please. Engage.
Nice clearance from Cusseter again. This is Henderson. Look for the one-handed offload to Hitchell Whip, but the cover was good. Parks to Murray. Huge tackle there by Smith. Parks again, bit of space here. This is Southwell and Henderson. Brendan Cannon was the tackler. 35 metres out from the Australian goal line. And this is where Scotland need to be very focused and really ram home this advantage. No mistakes. Grimes bouncing off defenders like a pinball. This is little Cusseter. Great burst by Henderson Smith. Webster, beautiful hands to Southwell. Now Henderson, Gitto underneath. That's the corner line.
The Wallabies are very passive in defence. They need to move up. They're not dominating in the tackle. And that's allowing the Scotlands too much continuity.
Now Daniel Parks working to Grimes. That's the way to do it. Huge hit from Samo. He's hurt his left arm, it seems. Great concern. He's holding his left wrist. Field goal's on. Has he got the legs?
Offside.
Big groan in the Wallaby camp because Arandiki
retired behind the offside line.
Has taken a very nasty knock on that left arm.
Never move far enough, mate. We're still a half minute.
It's a penalty to Scotland, too.
Well, hopefully he's only got what's called a burner, which is a sting.
It's 18-12 to the Wallabies, but a kick to come here for the Scots after that very good passage of play.
Well, originally the penalty came because Justin Harrison, as that was concerted effort by the Scottish, being just that little bit lazy, not getting back an extra half a metre, picked up by the referee, and allows the Scottish to get that momentum back into the game.
Radicki, there he goes. His left shoulder. He doesn't want to come off in his first test match.
Maybe he won't have any choice as Daniel Parks looks to close the six-point deficit. And he's been on the money. An exemplary kicking performance from Daniel Parks. His fifth penalty, 5 from 5. And there's 3 points in it.
The Scottish so far have been doing well. They haven't had much opportunity to be within 30 metres of the Australian goal line, but every time they've done that, they've been able to come away with points. And that's what it's all about, taking the most of your opportunities.
So Dickie Somo stays on. Phil Ward goes back to his seat. Australia taking play down inside the Scottish quarter. This is Cassetto looking for someone to pass to. And that sure right boot of Daniel Parks takes play just outside the quarter. He wanted more territory there.
This is where Australia have to start upping their tempo. They have to do it in defence. They have to do it in attack. They've got to speed this game up. The Scottish have been very good at slowing it down.
Roger, Roger!
Somo's recovered well. Another fine pass in front of the man from Regan. It's Rathbone just short of the quarter.
Easy, on the ball, on the ball.
In the end, George, with no choice, he had to just paddle it back. Nathan Sharp makes a couple of defenders with him. And the ball coming slowly.
Can't roll clear. He couldn't roll clear. So you're going forward, Gold. Your scrum.
14 minutes elapsed in this second half. Australia 18, Scotland 15. Australia 2-0. But Daniel Parks, with 5 penalties, has kept the visitors in touch.
Hand up!
Tight head, Blue. Dropping your binding.
Yeah, Scotland there, the drop of the bind, letting go of the grip so he could try and let the scrum come back on his side and try and wheel the Australians around.
He's renowned on the bagpipes, Bruce Douglas. He looks to be a little short of breath at the moment as Phil Moore is poised to come onto the field. And he'll be coming on, I think, for George Smith. So it all happened on the other side of the scrum as far as the Scots are concerned. Sharp. Brigger. Larkham Gitto stepping off his right boot. Scotland's defence scrambles. Somo, huge tackle by Hitchelwood. Australia asking big questions now in the Scottish defence. Probing for their third try. Larko, so close. Here it comes for Brigger. They're queuing up on the short side. Somo's there. Little talking by the Scots. Right side to
the Scottish players getting off the front foot, coming forward and putting the Wallabies under so much pressure in defence.
Terrific communication by the Scots here. They're working as one.
Ball's out, play on, lost forward.
Murray's come through and then lost to hands.
Lost forward, blue four, trying to pick it up.
Gregan was tangled up in the ruck, I think. But willing defence from the Scots as Australia threw everything at them.
Great defence by the Scottish team. One, two, three, four tackles. And they pushed Australia back and put them under pressure. Australia had no answer.
They beat Brendan Cannon, one of the great runners of the ball in tight, getting absolutely poleaxed.
18-15 Australia.
Easy! Break it up. Eight! Eight! Go! Easy!
Stephen Larkham actually went in there to pull Ali Hogg away. He saw something. And Sabo was there initially.
Meanwhile, you've got Scott Murray in the background.
Just on your voice.
He's in Gaga.
Time off, Gallo. Yeah. Yeah, it was. Yeah. Yep.
So the touch judges George. Are communicating, and there's a big... Now, that wasn't a tackle, it was a shoulder judge.
Yeah, right here. Okay, believe it or not, Scott, you started all that because you came in with a shoulder charge. That's what the penalty was for originally, okay? I want six as well. Six. And you're number eight? Your number eight, please. Your number eight?
Hoggy. I'll say Hoggy.
Your number eight?
Hoggy. Sorry, sir. It's a big fella.
Yeah, it was a shoulder charge. Keep the testosterone levels down, okay? You just lost your cool there for 5 seconds. Let's not have any more. I don't want to see you coming in and helping me out, all right? You're not wearing a blue and orange jersey, okay? So just stay right out of it. We're going to go with the original penalty, which is against you for a shoulder charge.
Yeah, sorry, sir.
Let's tone it all down, okay? Champion, thank you.
Well, shoulder I think that's good referee from Paul Honus in the players in and making sure they understand where they stand up. But David Lyons, Scotty Murray, bang. Scott Murray saying to the referee, sir, I couldn't remember.
I don't think David Lyons will remember too much.
And what was Larkham doing? He's like a little fox terrier going in there. He's playing way above his weight.
Well, he saw that man, Ali Hogg, coming to the rescue of Scott Murray, and he made sure that he pulled him away. I think he was a good Samaritan there, Steve Larkham. Incidentally, his World Cup diary is out, the book, and he rates the 2003 Wallaby World Cup team above the winning 1999 World Cup team. Joe Rock to squeeze it out to a 6-point advantage. Just caressing that ball through. So breathing space for the Wallabies. But for how long?
Well, having this shot has showed me up. I'm talking about three pairs before the game. They didn't need it. They're really putting it on the line here and giving the Wallabies a big run for their money.
The Scots have shown a lot of spine.
Keep your time running, Carlo.
They've really taken the game to the Wallabies. Wallabies. They've had to do a lot of defending, and Scott Murray, after that last confrontation, is very much the worse for wear. And we have a replacement coming on in Ian Fullerton.
In position, you're okay to go.
Eddie Jones also making some changes with Daniel Vickerman coming on.
Australia by 21 to 15. It's been Scott on the brain.
Touch off blue, gold line.
In this opening match in the Bundaberg Rugby Series. And the Wallabies now with the Spirit of Australia, Qantas, the new major sponsor of the Wallaby team.
Off the mark, blue. Off the mark, one.
Let's see the throw accuracy of Cannon and the timing when he's jumping.
Go, go, go!
That's not the big play.
No problems. Sailor. Wendell Sailor's been looking for work. And he's been very busy. Taken away by Jason White. He's had a terrific day in the Scottish back line. Tarks quickly to Bullock. Gitto taken by a lovely offload. Over the touchline.
Wendell Sutton, there we see Wendell Sutton coming in off his wing. Lucky enough for Australia, they forced him across the touchline. Australia get the feed. So they're looking to get involved on both sides of the field tonight.
Strong jump at the front there by Dan Vickerman.
Holding gold.
Markham's kick, no touch. Webster then quickly to Southwell. Webster on the loop. Rogers covered up well, but it's a tricky bounce. And eventually comes good.
Super 12, still trying to be involved.
Nicky Samo to Larkham. And seeing there was no one in the box covering that wing, cuts it to the halfback, scurries. And Southwell charged down there. Great work by Harrison. How's that for mobility from the big man? Now to Keeley. Spider piece of play there by Justin Harrison. Following up the Larkham kick. Gitto.
Ball's out, play on.
Loose ball.
Play on.
Rathbone now. Phil Warren inside supports. Scott really scrambling. And Regan's
caught. Out again. And off
came through. Australia looking numbers at the breakdown to protect it. Now get out to Kerry's outside. Can he score number two? Lockie to Kerry. The Fijians will be dancing and celebrating because that's a major money blow for the Scots.
Well, that's all the Wallabies needed. They need to start creating a bit more width in their game. Been playing it close. That's all they needed to get Rock to feed to Kerry wide. Gitto early on, but Gitto hasn't had a lot of chances tonight, but he needs to find more space. And a great try for the Wallabies.
But you put that try down to, not to Kerry, but you put it down to Justin Harrison. That's twice in the last couple of minutes, a covering tackle to put the Scottish into touch, and then to be able to do that charge down, which put Australia into the position. And again, they give it to the finisher in to Kerry. Had just that ounce of room on the outside, and that's all the big fella needs to go over.
Sean Lamont just gave him too much room on the outside. The Wallabies staying to get their patterns. It's taken a while for them tonight, but Takiri's got a lot off his mind during the week.
So Brendan Cannon departs. Jeremy Paul comes on. Justin Harrison has dropped body fat this season. He's leaned up to help his work rate. It certainly paid off there. This to make it 28 to 15. He gets the distance. 25 minutes elapsed in the second half. Australia now out by 13. And the Wallabies have certainly just cranked it up in this final quarter of the game. Saylor does well to stay in field. Larkham to Rock. And he's rifled it. Southwell. Taken by Harrison again. And here goes to Kerry. Desperate defence by Stuart Graves.
Still play it.
Referee playing advantage.
Ran offside.
See, look at the bench. Bench there with Rathbone off. Bergmann, looks like Berg has slid to fullback with Roth going to the wing. And during the week, there he is, Matt Berg, been handed by a thigh muscle strain. Been able to get on there. Been one of Australia's great warriors over the last decade. It's great to see him out there.
He's 12 seasons of international rugby. Two more subs coming on for the Scots here. Numbers 17 and 19, Craig Smith, the front rower, and also John Petrie, a very experienced back rower from Glasgow. Departing McFadgen and also White, and Chris Latham is out there as well.
Chris Latham back in his customary 15 position.
David Lyons after some bloodbend treatments after that clash with Scott Murray and Justin Harrison. Googie will be thrilled with his performance. Lovely finger work handling by Regan. This is Rock. The overlap's here. Saylor into Webster. Just 5 metres to go for Gregan. It's Nathan Sharp. Gitto came in to try and scurry the ball back.
He's getting infringement from this player down here. Advantage goals.
Phil Ward. Scottish player was ruled offside there. Coming through on Gregan prematurely.
Still playing advantage goals. No advantage. Blue one interfering with the halfback without the ball.
Wallabies would probably have liked a little more advantage there because the Scots were fully stretched.
Roll right out, guys. Don't interfere with the halfback without the ball.
Here we see on Qantas wing cam.
Hold the goal line, please.
Chris Latham getting his hands on the ball early. And Wendell Saylor did extremely well to stay in field. As Australia, George Gregan opts to take the line out.
Great call by George. He wants to keep putting the screws on the Scottish and he wants to make sure that his men are working hard in all facets of the game.
Goal line.
And Saylor's certainly done that in attack. Lost by Sharp. Knock on. Referee plays advantage for Scotland.
Late in touch.
And that's a searching kick up the touchline by Daniel Parks, who's kicked 5 penalties for the men in blue.
Just a slight bit of timing error there, just a fraction too long.
And the 5, play.
Here's Larkham, Kiddo, and he's hit. Straight into Parks. Good clean out from the Wallaby forwards, though. Vickerman. 12 minutes remaining for Larkham. Lovely ball there for Saylor. Scottish defence being fully stretched now by the men in goal, who are enjoying a mountain of possession.
Nothing.
But still the Scottish team defending so bravely. Space here for Latham. Larkham goes himself and is crunched backwards.
In the back 80.
It's a Sharp. Takes on 2. Very close for Toll.
Lovely here, one, lovely.
Now Latham. Gitto. By the bootlace. Quick ball needed.
From the side, advantage goals. Coming out of a close.
Coming in on the side.
Still advantage to you, goals.
Wallabies one advantage here.
No advantage. 12, blue, in from the side. 12, blue.
We'd expect George Green to take the scrum. Keep the pressure on the Scots. Interesting stat so
just
far.
Just remember where you are. I don't want your players giving away penalties in the zone, OK?
Australia only made 55 tackles to Scotland's 92. Scotland have missed 18 scrum. Tackles.
Scrum time, goals.
It's important here, Australia have got a good position here like they did that last morning. They've got to make sure it's a good, solid scrum.
Yeah, just wait for my call. Just go down and wait. Engage.
You've got Wendell Saylor on the right side.
Wake up, fellas.
That's a mighty Scottish scrum.
She's starting to screw before the ball went in. Let's have it. Square and stationary before the ball comes in, please.
Australia dominating possession, as mentioned.
No, not now. Not now.
Also won the second half ruck and ball by 54 to 18. So it's a 3-1 ratio.
That's gone.
Matthew Burke, well, happy to go to ground. This is Latham.
Hold.
Larkham with Phil Moore. Has the kick gone too far? Rock comes through and it beats everyone.
22.
Yes. Beautifully placed as it turned out. It bounced on
number
its
nine
end.
And number 10 blue. Substitution.
Back towards the goal line.
Come off, Carlo.
It shows you how good the Scottish defence goal. Has been tonight by Larkin putting the ball in behind. That close to the line.
9 and 10 blue.
The Scottish side makes some changes.
As does Australia, we see Matt Dunne coming on for Bill Young. Won't he be relishing the chance? It is the big fella relishing the chance to have a go at this Scottish tackle.
Chris Latham there. Running back. Scottish chasers. Smart work there by Jeremy Paul. Griggan is a second receiver to Sharp and Saylor. Pushes off Webster. And a crunching tackle by Southwell in the last line. But another massive chance there by Big Dell.
But what a tackle by Southwell. As the Scots play on quickly. See on Qantas wing cam pick up Wendell Saylor down the right hand side for Australia. Bang, have that. But then Southwell, as he's done all night, made some try-saving tackles on Wendell Saylor.
Look at Lamont there. He's jumped up at him like an angry koala, but of course he's been brushed off. He's been doing well all night. But then look at Wendell steaming ahead.
Wallabies just having so much possession, and Stephen Larkin playing with the defence. Tall and Larkin. Line out for Scotland, 6 metres out. Scrum half. He goes Webster. Oh, It's a kick. Christmas has come early for Wendell Saylor. Unmarked man inside. And that really has buried the Scots. But the scoreboard doesn't tell the real story of their very courageous performance.
Wendell's taken that two-hand scab to the line. Then played up to the camera, but I don't know how much Joe Roth will be happy because he hasn't advanced it for his kicking.
It was a lovely ball wide for Webster. He had a chance to get redemption against Saylor, but Saylor just plucked it out of the air. There wasn't much he had to do to get to the line, Wendell Saylor. And he's been pretty active tonight, popping up on the left and right hand side of the field.
He was very lucky that it wasn't a good kick there for Wendell as well. He hasn't got him any easier than that, because behind Wendell Saylor there was nothing but the try line for Lamont. So he went from having a good position to being down by another try.
So Simon Webster pushed off earlier and then electing to kick. And he'll have nightmares about that one. So to Southwell, who is inside. Matthew Burke then, back in the familiar goal-kicking role, and he hasn't lost anything, has he? 20-point lead for the Wallabies.
Isn't it great to see that man, Matt Burke, back on the field, not wanted by New South Wales next year. Only 6 minutes to go, and the Wallabies still have time to put points on the board.
Crowd of just over 38,000 has enjoyed the action. And Gordon Ross now, probably more of a playmaker than Daniel Parks, on a fly half for the Scots. Was that lost ahead? Referee said.
Four goals. Scrum down, blue ball.
Daniel Bickerman initially taking that well with two hands. This is where Australia have to be clinical in their performance. They have to make sure the start of the season, everything they do is precise through to the final whistle.
Ben by Mike Lear. This is Ross.
Lost forward blue. I just couldn't quite see it again. And then that was a win. Cheers.
But the Scots moving the ball, shifting it into space very well. Just their hands letting them down. Insurance pass. It's going to be a difficult one there for Southwell. Still should have been taken. Here goes Southwell. Has certainly performed splendidly. The Scots.
Six.
2 minutes to go.
Goal line. That's fine.
Last beat.
Scotland now.
Lost forward.
And they have just spoilt themselves.
Hard luck, Blue.
Tragically.
Lost forward. Some goals.
All that good work done. A knock on. You can see the disappointment.
Steve's got someone from his side just put a boot on the ball just before he picked it up. So it wasn't quite where his hand thought it was.
He's had a bit of a bow too with the opposition. Matt Geddo down hole, clutching his ribs.
Australia 35, Scotland 15. That's Matt Dunning.
Is it Dunning, is it?
So it's a fat Matt Geddo.
I was going to say, same coloured headgear, but very different body.
As Brendan Cannon said, he's a big kid in a large man's body.
Come on, Gold. Come on to the mark, Gold. Just wait, crouch and hold.
Matt Dunning also came on in the World Cup final last year.
Engage. Gold.
And Chris Latham. Happy to get that one into touch. And try and deprive the Scots of this try that they're desperately seeking.
Well, the Scottish, you can't have a go at them about lack of enthusiasm. They're playing this game right down to the death.
Off goal, advantage Blue.
Smith cleared it well to Blair. Great charge by Petrie.
Advantage over.
Blair again to Ross. This is Webster. And a couple of Wallabies sweating on him.
Off goal.
Including Matthew Burke. Tom Smith.
Lay on. Lay on.
Pass in field, Wallabies have scavenged.
Break up.
Stuart Grimes getting a little carried away there as he
break up.
Scaled.
Going backwards, Blue, your scrum goals. Five, come out of check.
Countdown by the crowds, Cooter about to go.
Just to give him a reminder, he's been there for the day.
Catch and hold.
Little Highland flick.
Hey guys, here's our mark here. Can we come up please, Blue?
Inside the last minutes.
Back up with gold. Back up gold room. Catch and hold here. Break up. Done good. Break up. One six. Literally set up. Catch and hold. Engage. Let's go. Nah, they just both packs slipped. They both slipped. Yeah. Look at hey guys, just a little closer together, right? It's a bit soft on top, a little closer together. Crouch and hold. Engage.
And Gitto tucking that one into the touchline. And the final whistle goes here at Telstra Dome. The Aussies with 3 second half tries. And finally down the Scots by 35 to 15 after there was just a point in it at halftime.
Well, Australia knew right from the outset that it was going to be a hard game and the Scottish weren't going to lie down. They can hold their heads high, the Scottish. They really made Australia work for their points. I don't think that the score actually gave a true indication of the game, and we've been set up now for a cracker in the second.
The Scots certainly had to do it without the ball in the second half, but they showed fantastic heart, ticker, as you call it, and they really played the game right to the wire and almost got their try. But the Wallabies have come away with 4 tries, and in the end, they've got to be pleased with that.